Hi there, I'm AJ from AJ's Design Lab. When we talk about software and tools that web designers use every day, one of the first that comes to mind is HTML or text editors. Which one's better? Today I'm going to look at two of them, Sublime Text and Atom, and I may as well cut straight to the chase and tell you that I'm going to pick Sublime Text every day of the week. As to why, I can probably answer it with this scenario. If I was offered the choice to use Atom for a day, or be forced to sit down and listen to a long playlist of Taylor Swift music, then much as I dislike Taylor Swift's stuff, I'm going to choose her every time. The reason is, Atom is so slow. It's ridiculous. Now that's not just me. It's the same on any system. It's well known. I'll just give you an example of that and I'll start up Atom. So we'll just wait for a little while. It's thinking about it and it's having another quick think. Not ready yet. Are we getting there? But still not ready to use yet. Still not ready to use. Ah, here we go. So I'm not sure how long that took, but it was quite a while. Let me compare it to Sublime Text. Let's just start that up. Well, that was blisteringly fast in comparison. So with Atom, I'm afraid the speed is just a deal breaker for me. I've got things to do and it's just driving me mad. I cannot wait that long, type a line of text and then wait for the cursor to catch up. Takes ages to boot up, previewing a page takes forever, everything that you do takes longer. And the more files you have, the longer it takes. Now if I want to preview my page here in Sublime Text, I'll just right click here, select open in browser, and there we go, it's open. So as far as speed goes, Sublime Text has it all over Atom. Now one of the things that you want to consider when you're choosing an editor is what's the package management system like. And if you're not familiar with the term packages, think of it as being the same as extensions for your Chrome or Firefox browser, or perhaps plugins for WordPress theme. Just basically bits of code that you install which make your job easier and customize things to the way you want them. That may not have come out with the default settings. Now if you want to learn Sublime Text, there's a really great channel on YouTube called Learn Web Code, and I'll put the link to that in the description and perhaps the video. There's a series of 12 videos on learning Sublime Text. If you haven't got time to watch all 12, then at least watch the first one and then the one on installing packages, which I think is number 5, and number 7, which is about Emmet. And that's really going to be all you need. I promise you, if you use Sublime Text, you won't regret it. If there are drawbacks, and I'm sure raving Atom fans will point this out, one of them is that it takes more initial work to set up Sublime Text the way you want it than Atom does. Atom has a nicer interface. But it's a one-off job setting up the package managers and installing packages. Once you've done it, you don't have to do it again. And the other thing is, Sublime Text comes with a free trial that lasts forever. And as long as you don't mind clicking the reminder to buy, then you can keep it for free for as long as you like. Atom is totally free and there's no purchase option. So those are the only two ways that Atom has it over Sublime Text, in my opinion. Anyway, I hope this helped, and we'll catch up with you next time. Bye for now. If you enjoyed this video, then you can subscribe to my channel and click this icon to get notified about new videos. And of course, a thumbs up is always appreciated. Thanks for watching.